everyone, and welcome to another video, and welcome to a very interesting sort of topic that today that I have selected. Now, if you, this is very specific to India currently. So if you live in India, you would have heard about this news about the automobile industry shifting to the BS6 engines. Now, India recently introduced the BS6 standards, which is the Bharat Standard 6. So that was implemented from 1st of April 2020. That means the previous vehicle, which were the BS4, they were all going to be ruled out, but not the existing one. So today's video, we're going to be discussing that, about how it affects you as a buyer, or if you are a someone who owns a BS4 vehicle currently and someone who's going to buy a new vehicle, how are you going to be affected in detail. And also we'll be understanding how a BS6 engine works in a very quick sort of explanation that I'll be giving you around. So let's start understanding how a BS6 engine first works. Before we move forward, please consider subscribing to my channel and make sure to press the bell icon so that you never miss any video updates from my channel. Now, to understand the BS6 engine's working, it's a little different than the BS4 engine, which has been just phased out. So there are a few components that's been added to the BS6 engine. Now, first of all, I'm going to be showing you like a diagram. So let me open that up. So what we'll do is I'll be posting it from my laptop onto your screen in... So now, as you see it on your screen, the diagram represents a BS4 engine. So the basic components that start with are the engine, and then the exhaust gas comes into the turbocharger, and then the turbocharger will eventually feed it to the first component of the BS6 engine, which is the diesel particulate filter. Now, that will basically absorb all the soot that is present in the gases, and then from that stage onwards, from the diesel particulate filter, it will go on to the SCR, which is selective catalytic reduction. Now, the selective catalytic reduction is where everything happens majorly, because I'm going to be discussing the figures also, how much to what extent does it help in removing these harmful gases. So the selective catalytic reduction is, if you see from the diagram, it's connected to an AdBlue or the diesel exhaust fluid, which is like a tank, which is around 10 liters or 10 plus liters. It varies around that, but that has the fluid inside it, which helps in reduction of these harmful gases. So now this AdBlue substance, the fluid, has two parts of deionized water and hydrogen, and one part of urea. Now what happens is, when these gases from the diesel particulate filter enter into the SCR, so I'll just be referring to the selective catalytic converter as the SCR. So the SCR, when AdBlue reacts with the gases first, so what the urea does is it converts the gases into carbon dioxide and nitrogen oxides. Now in the SCR core, what happens is the carbon dioxide is emitted after that, but the nitrogen oxide again reacts to produce ammonia and water. Yes, that's the best thing about this. So it produces water and nitrogen, and then that is basically exits out from the exhaust tip. So now what happens is this whole process is where the diesel particulate filter and the SCR have been introduced in the BS6 engine, and which is why this engine needs a lot of development, especially for the manufacturer. So now again, the reductions in out of this system, the benefits that you get are immense. So if we are talking about nitrogen reduction, especially in diesel engines, now diesel engines are the engines that been particularly in focus for the reduction of the harmful gases, because as you know, they release particulate filter, they also release nitrogen oxides and a lot of harmful gases, and the more you try to reduce this, the efficient the engine is going to be. So what It actually helps in reducing up to 70% of nitrogen oxides in a diesel engine and 25% in a petrol engine. Now that's a very large gain if you compare to the previous generation, and in order to cut down on the pollution. But I know this is a drastic change for the manufacturers also, and as a result of that, I'm also going to be discussing now that how it affects you as a customer. So if you have a BS6 engine, the Bharat Stage 6 engine, then here are the things which is different than a standard BS4 engine, which is just being phased out. So the first thing that you would require is a new type of oil for the system, because obviously the engine has a different sort of functioning from inside, for which it's a little on the technical side. And also the fuel has to be different, because the previous generation of fuels that were there, they would produce somewhere between, the sulfur content in diesel would be around 50 parts per million, and in the newer fuels, the diesel, which is for the BS6, for that there is only 10 parts per million of sulfur content which is allowed, and that is a massive difference, which is about 5 times. So it reduces that also, and eventually the sulfur will be emitted, which will be from the exhaust tips, also will be reduced, and that's like a big shift from the standard engines. Now as a customer, obviously what you can expect is that the prices of the engine, because the manufacturers are going to develop these engines for initial adopters, they are going to be a little expensive, because this is just the first year when these engines have been introduced, and for that reason the development cost is also going to fall on the customer. The oil and the petrol and the diesel, which is especially for the BS6 now, that is still under control, because that hasn't changed by a lot. Again, the more people start adopting this technology, the easier it is going to be for the companies to sell these in volume and then reduce the cost of it. So as a customer, it's not a loss, because eventually you are still going to save in terms of the pollution that the vehicles are going to be, the older generation of BS4 that are going to be producing. So in terms of that, you are already advanced into the next sort of cleaner generation of cars. Also, another benefit will be the addition of OBD in the newer cars, which is your onboard diagnostic tool, and also the RDE, which is your road driving emission. So now these will be on board on the car itself, so that it will be easier to track the pollution of the car. And also for the diesel car, they are going to be introducing the DCP and the SCR, which I've already discussed, the diesel particulate filter, sorry, DPF. I don't know why do I keep saying DCF, but it's DPF. So diesel particulate filter and the SCR, which is your selective catalytic reduction. The next question is, can the BS4 vehicles use the same BS6 fuels? Now for the petrol cars, it's still going to be all right. I mean, there isn't going to be much of a difference, but for the diesel car, there are a lot of things that will change. Now the first thing is, because as I mentioned, the fuel is different for a BS6 engine, so it has low sulfur content, and also the diesel engines, they have ionizers, like the fuel injectors, that ionizes fuel inside your head. So as a result of that, also the sulfur is acting as a lubricant inside these injectors, so they help in making sure that the injectors remain smoothly operational. So as a result of that, because of the reduction in the sulfur content, what will happen is they will be going through a stress cycle, and meaning there will be a lot of failures of the diesel injectors, not immediately, but the life of these injectors are going to be reduced if you are on the BS6 fuel. The sulfur content is essential to keep these injectors also clean, and as a result of that, this is the biggest disadvantage that a BS4 car is going to have. But there are additives which are going to be available, so they will be already mixed, so you have to just make sure that you pre-inform, or you have the fuel which is mixed with those additives, so that these the drawback of the sulfur content is already being nullified with the addition of these additives. The next question is, can the BS6 engine work on a BS4 fuel? Again, for the petrol engine, it doesn't really matter because as I mentioned before, it was around 25% that it was making a difference. But it's for the diesel engines where everything happens to just, be a very drastic sort of change. So again, for the BS6 engine, if you use a BS4 fuel, the sulfur content is high. Now the BS6 engines are meant to work on a low sulfur content fuel, so as a result of that, it will affect the SCR performance, the selective catalytic reduction. So that will be majorly affected because it's not meant to handle so much of sulfur content. Also, over the time, you would have to use a lot of SCR fuel, which was mentioned before. So that SCR fuel, the life of it is around 10,000 kilometers per tank of it. So every 10 liters of tank would be doing around 10,000 kilometers. So after that, you will have to fill those tanks again with that, along with the fuel. So that is one thing which has changed in the BS6 engine. Also, the diesel particulate filter will also be used up a lot, meaning a lot of soot will be consumed by them, and also they will also be need to be replaced very often if you use the BS4 fuels in the BS6. Also, the usage of the BS4 fuels in the BS6 engines would mean that the fuel efficiency also would reduce, not dramatically, but it will be affected for sure. So those were the differences between the BS4 engine and a BS6 engine, and this is what was important to understand, the basic functioning of both these sort of different type of technologies, because they are, the BS6 is miles ahead in terms of the BS4 engine, and which is why it's a little expensive. And in comparison, if you compare it with the BS4 cars currently available in India, so the new BS6 cars are going to be around 10% more than the usual BS4 run cars. So that's just the slight amount that you have to pay for now, but then in the longer run, these cars actually help in reducing a lot of pollution, and also they are going to be much more greener, and they are going to be ahead, because if you know the BS, the bar standard which is being followed by India is in line with the European standard. So the European norms also, whenever they are out, it's when India's norms are also being updated. So you know that these emission laws are at par with the European rules that are being placed out there. So in a way, it's pretty good to be advanced that way. Also, by paying slight premium, you are updated to the newer generation of cars, and a lot of manufacturers have already put their plans in to start the production, and some have already started putting their cars out in the market, which all the BS6 with the BS6 engines. Anyways, give it a thumbs up if you like this video, and if you want to subscribe to my channel, then click here, and if you want to watch more videos, then click here, and if you have any suggestions, then make sure to write them down in the comment section below. Until we meet next time, bye bye and stay safe.